to the soul or to the body of the one who died, let's say, in the ocean. There's no body. The body is in the ocean, Zakallah. And what will happen to the one who is not actually buried, you know, under the ground, as we do, like Muslims or Christians or Jews? What about those who are on fire, like Hindus? Or what about those who died, let's say, in the forest? Let's say a tiger or a lion, leopard, attack them and you know, cut them body into pieces. What will happen to them? Now, we know that, you know, we heard right now and the last week that once the body goes inside the qabr, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the ruh again to the qabr, and then things will start. How then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with the one who died, like, you know, on fire or in the forest or in the beach, in the sea, in the ocean, like in other way, there is no body. Just to let you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created us from ruh and from jasad. In this dunya, the ruh taba' lil jasad. The ruh, the soul, as the ulama said, the soul is following the body. So whatsoever you do, the soul will do it. So a person is drinking alcohol, the soul, again, have to follow it. The person is lying and cheating and doing sins and ma'asi and whatsoever, the ruh is following it, you know. And this is what the ulama said, that ruh taba' lil jasad fi dunya. Then in the grave, it will be opposite. The jasad will be taba'an lil ruh, that the body will follow the ruh. That what will happen to the ruh, the jasad will have to follow it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with ruh, and then what will happen to the ruh from the na'im, from the punishment, from the sins, or from the blessings whatsoever, the ruh, this will happen to the ruh, the body will follow it. In al-akhirah, this is what the ulama said, in al-akhirah, in the Jannah or Nar, in the hellfire or in the paradise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with both simultaneously. So the ruh and jasad, the body and the ruh, will be simultaneously. Both will get the same thing, either it's a punishment or it's a blessing. So both in the same thing. So now the one who died and the body is not exist, either it's cut into pieces or an animal ate it or whatsoever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with the ruh and with al-ghayb, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with the body, you know, simultaneously. So this is the answer, is that if a person dies and there is no body of that person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with the ruh and the body will follow it, even though we see that the body is not there, the body is, you know, into ashes or into pieces or whatsoever, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal first with the soul and the body will follow it. And in al-akhirah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with both simultaneously. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our ruh, our soul and our body from the people of the Jannah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen.